national organization promotes all aspects of music creation, performance, and scholarship, and encourages service for music on the campus, in the community, and throughout the world. Some of our organization's national service projects include donations of music and instruments to developing countries, scholarships, grants, and loans for continuing education or instrument purchase, music therapy and services for musicians with special needs, and awards for summer music study. Locally, our chapter, the Volusia County Alumni, have donated almost $20,000 over the years to community music projects. These contributions include scholarships to individuals, grants to the Deltona Philharmonic and Flagler Strings for music and instrument purchases, donations to the Stetson Community School to provide lessons for students who cannot afford study, and many grants to local school programs, including Southwesternville, Campbell Middle, and Sensula Academy. We have also sponsored instrument pedigrees and Girl Scout Music Badge Days as a way to bring music to the youth of our community. Any monies received this afternoon will go directly to our chapter. Your contributions today will allow us to continue our work in supporting music creation, performance, and education in the community. But enough of me talking. It's time to let these accomplished musicians and their mentor do what they do best. We are very grateful to Dr. Jones and his work in the studio.
very much for being here. It's a pleasure to do this again this year. In the past, we've done it with a larger number of students, and there are others studying organ and harpsichord right now, but they're mostly at rather beginning stages, so I'm doing it with these two cohorts today, James Agard, who's from Tallahassee, Florida, and Christopher Hodges, who is from Fredericksburg, Virginia, and you will hear them. I was asked to make a few remarks about the music. Buxtehude, of course, was the composer that Bach admired greatly and traveled a long distance on foot to meet and hear him play in Lübeck. The pieces that James will play here by Bach are from his Orgelbuchlein, which Albert Schweitzer termed the organist's Bible, little gems of small masterpieces. Following that, Christopher will play a piece from the Klavierbuchlein for Wilhelm Friedemann Bach by J.S. Bach, a little D major prelude, and a piece by François Couperin, Les Barricades Mystérieuses, which translates simply as the Mysterious Barricades. These French harpsichord pieces of the time had these somewhat enigmatic, evocative titles that we don't exactly know what they refer to in most cases. Sometimes they'll be a tribute to another composer, but whatever the Mysterious Barricades is, that's what this is about. James will follow with two very diverse, very different organ pieces. One of Brahms, Opus 122, Chorale Preludes. This is the last opus number of Brahms before he passed away. And an early work by the French composer Olivier Messiaen, his Apparition of the Eternal Church. Then I'll be back and talk more. So I hope you enjoy these pieces this afternoon. Thanks again for being here. Program Notes Part 2. You probably don't know the name Claude Babatra, but he was one of many, many French composers of this high Baroque period, as you see, a contemporary to some extent of Francois Couperin. What some Americans know of Claude Babatra is that prior to his presidency, Thomas Jefferson served as ambassador or whatever it was to France, and then during his time in Paris, his daughter studied with Babatra, and they were acquainted, and Jefferson had his pieces in his collection. In any event, that title is not really evocative of anything. That is simply to the name of the lady to whom he dedicated a book of pieces. All right, then Chris will follow with two pieces. A piece by a contemporary of Messiaen, Jean Longlet. Messiaen was at the Parisian Church of the Trinity. Longlet was at Saint Clotilde, where César Franck had been many years before. This piece, you see the French title, it's the tune that we more commonly know as Herzlich tut mich verlangen in German, or the English text you associate with the tune is O Sacred Head Now Wounded. And then the cantilena for organ is by Joseph Rheinberger, who has in common with Mendelssohn, who we'll hear a bit later, being a child prodigy type player. Rheinberger, a romantic German, who wrote a bunch of wonderful music but just never achieved quite the prominence of Mendelssohn and some other contemporaries. So you'll hear those, and I'll be back again. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mendelssohn, whose birthday we passed on February 3rd, just last Saturday. Mendelssohn, when he traveled to Great Britain, was as well known as an organist as anything else and was commissioned by a British firm, Coventry and Hollier, a printing company, to write organ pieces. And he came up with his six sonatas of Opus 65. I will be playing the sixth sonata. The beginning of it is a set of variations on a hymn tune, a chorale tune, Vater unser im Himmelreich, or Our Father who art in heaven, the Lord's Prayer setting. This is the entirety of the sixth sonata, even though it ends very quietly. Following that, James will play the second and fourth movements of the fourth sonata in B flat, and that ends more like a recital should end, with a more spectacular last movement. So the sixth sonata, and then the second and fourth movements of the fourth sonata.